Hi, Karina here, your Lucid Living Coach. How's everyone going? As you can see, I am not at my house. I am in Tahoe, where it's very cold. Literally went on a hike yesterday, went to sleep, and woke up to all this snow. So crazy. So, you know, new moon and Aries conjunct Uranus type energy for sure. Like, didn't expect this much snow when I woke up. It was, pleasant, but now I'm kind of snowed in. But I wanted to do a little video on Saturn retrograde that's happening tomorrow, April 17th. And Saturn will be retrograde until September 6th, around 4 a.m. So we have a good 5 months of Saturn being retrograde. What does that mean for us? Well, Saturn is the ruler of Capricorn. So it's definitely going to affect that Capricorn energy within our charts, okay? And the Capricorn type energy. So let me just explain a little bit about Capricorn and what it's associated with. So the color is the indigo. It's like the violet, right? So it connects us to this higher God type energy because it rules the three-dimensional reality. It rules the structure. And it's the karma planet. So have you guys ever noticed that if you guys go through like a lot of limiting things in life that you tend to reach towards spirituality, right? Or God, or, you know, if you're on your deathbed or whatever, you think that you're going to die, maybe, you know, like, hey, you know, if there's it is a God, please save me or help me. Okay. So I think that's my opinion as to why Saturn's associated with the purple, which is the crown chakra, okay? And if you didn't know this, Saturday, the day of the week, was actually named after Saturn. And Saturn, the planet, was named after the Roman god. As far as the tarot cards, it is the world. Because it does rule this three-dimensional reality, okay, the world. It exercises the principles of constriction, limitation, responsibility, and stability, okay? So if anyone knows of a Capricorn sun or a Capricorn moon or a Capricorn rising, you will definitely see how stable they are. Capricorn is a cardinal earth energy. So it initiates things and it gets things started. Okay. Without Saturn, we would just kind of just expand into nothing. You know, it kind of is like the gravity that the earth provides for us. Saturn and Jupiter work together. Saturn is the constrictor and Jupiter is the expander. So it's expanding. If we didn't have limitations, then we would just float off into the universe, right? So that's important. It plays an important role. Okay. Just like as our heart beats, the constricting would be Saturn, the expanding would be Jupiter. Saturn, even in the physical attributes of the planet itself, its rings resemble the confinements, right? It's confined. Saturn's confined within its rings. So even as a physical element that we see in the sky, it also represents the energy that it portrays, okay? So Saturn is associated with the yin, the feminine, the dark and the cold and the earth, okay? Like it is up here right now. Jupiter is associated with the yang, okay? The masculine, heaven, heat, and light. So with Saturn going retrograde, it means that the energy of the planet is closest to Earth. So as I talk about other retrogrades, it actually, because it's so loud, it shuts down. So we are going to be experiencing more of this luck and this freedom, but because it rules this cold and dark Earth, we could also be experiencing, maybe in government or politics or the world, more of a very, like warrior type behaviors, you know, maybe some war or combativeness of some kind, okay? Because it is the karma planet, and you get what you put in. Where have we not been honest with ourselves? Is there any stories that we continually tell ourselves? And it might not even be our stories, but it's maybe stories that we picked up from our past or our childhood or our parents that just no longer serve our higher purpose. The focus is on making ourselves the best version that we could be. And once we work on that, then we'll have more to offer in our relationships, in our partnerships, in our communities, and our future. Many healers are going to be digging deep and taking action on our work and the mission in the world. Okay? So everything that we've been rethinking during the Mercury retrograde, it's time to, now that Mercury's going direct, it's time to take action on those. And Saturn being retrograde is helping us really be able to embrace that Jupiter, that luck, that expansion, that hope. You know, we're going to be feeling that hope. And the focus is on also the shadow sides of things, because Jupiter is now in Scorpio. You know, it's been in Scorpio since October and it's expanding this deep transformation. This is also helping us clear these karmic cycles, okay? And healing from the past, realizing that the stories and boundaries that we create, either to keep us safe or that we've picked up, and these limitations that we put on ourselves may be keeping us from our true divinity and in turn keep us in this karmic pattern. So let's see the true beauty that resides within and embrace our values. See how far that we have come and be able to express our truths without fear. This could shift in our personal beliefs and our perceptions as well about reality. Because Saturn is in the home of Capricorn, we will be rethinking and create tangible plans towards our mission in the world and to help build our empire. So if it is a family that you want, or a business, or a creative project, or maybe getting back in school, whatever it is that you have been wanting and desiring, it's time to start taking steps towards your goal and your purpose. And this Saturn is self-mastery, and mastery is a process. I will have some quotes that I'll type for the end of this video so you can see some of the quotes. They're beautiful quotes by Saturn. But Saturn's at 9 degrees and 9 minutes. For 6 days, it'll be stationary in the aspect to Earth. 9 degrees is like infinity, right? 9 multiplied by any number always brings us back to 9. 9 is a very spiritual, collective, beginning and end type of number. And so I think that's all I really wanted to talk about, but I will pull a card for this 5-month cycle. Oops, there it goes. There's one for Saturn going retrograde. All right, so I have acceptance of love, which is number 38, and show your support, card 40. Ooh, the sun's coming out. Yay! This image is a representation of the harmony of opposites, masculine and feminine. Okay, that's just like Saturn and Jupiter. You have the ability to give love freely to yourself and to others. It is important to understand that you are whole, complete, and perfect now, and will enhance your life of another. Love can happen. Love is the truth of all situations. Love the soul embodied inside you. Express more love in your life and allow yourself to feel loved. Everything happens exactly when it's supposed to. In that order, everything that happens is what is supposed to take place. You bring a bright light and individuality into this world. Okay, that's beautiful. And then 40, show your support, is take time to encourage a colleague, coworker, family member, or friend. Be strong, shoulder, and willing volunteer to run errands. Provide a safe space for others' concerns and feelings to be discussed, and be a good listener. Jump in on providing extra time. Sponsor someone else's work. Share in someone's success. All of nature continually shows us the value in creating a strong network. The tree provides shelter and support for many different inhabitants. We are a community, and when we support each other, everyone gains. That's beautiful. And then the two tarot cards that I picked for this is the Five of Swords, and which is kind of along the same line as the Oracle cards that I picked. But it's pretty much just like taking care of yourselves, and taking care of ourselves is helping take care of others. Because if we don't fill up our own cup first, how are we supposed to fill up the other people's cups, right? Because we'll have nothing to give. But this card is also saying that giving too much and you're being taken advantage of, just set yourself free from it. You're worn out by demands, and take care of yourself. It's all about taking care of yourself. And through that, you can help take care of others. I also pulled the Ten of Cups, which I love this card. All the hard work that you put in, you'll get exactly what you've worked hard for. Okay, see, this is like a happy, loving couple and their kids, and they're all celebrating like their good fortune and their abundance. So these are two really good cards. So just keep on working and accept love and show love to others and support others in their growth. Yeah. So that's pretty awesome. I will now let you guys go. I hope you liked my video. I hope that helped a little bit. I am freezing. My little phalanges, they're frozen. The sun's finally out. Look at that. Just so beautiful. See? Well, if you liked my video, please subscribe and like and share. Take advantage of it. Take advantage of these 5 months. They are really open doors for us, okay? Because the Lord of Constriction is on a little net. First you lose trust, and I get worried. Night after night, bar after club, dropping like flies. I woke you up on the front lawn, spirits around. It's not your house, where'd you go wrong? Did you get married, and if you're sorry? You get excited, you gotta feel it.